Welcome to Psychology to Daf. We are in Gemara Yoma Daf Samach Dalhad, and today we'll talk about certain sins that you're allowed to do. So the Gemara Nomad Aleph discusses a scenario where it's necessary to slaughter an animal to feed an ill person on Yom Kippur. Now in this scenario, the Gemara assumes that there's no other meat available, and thus the mother goat of the Seir Lazazel, of the scapegoat, needs to be slaughtered for this purpose. This then raises the problem of the scapegoat being Mechusar Zaman, invalid due to a time-dependent qualification. In this case, the prohibition of slaughtering the mother goat and the child goat on the same day would make the scapegoat temporarily invalid for the service. Now, according to Halacha, if someone needs to eat meat on Yom Kippur, or even a regular Shabbos, and there is the option of available non-kosher meat, or the option to slaughter an animal and prepare kosher meat, you have a basic dilemma. What is better, to avoid violating the Shabbos by eating the available non-kosher meat? Or is it better to slaughter the animal and violate the Shabbos, thereby committing one momentary sin and avoiding the continuous sin of consuming each and every kazayas of non-kosher meat? Now, logic would dictate that since everything is permitted in order to preserve life, why not just feed the person the non-kosher meat? What reason would justify an additional prohibition of slaughtering on Shabbos? Yet Shulchan Aruch in Or HaChaim Shin Chav Ches Sif Yadalot rules that it is preferable to slaughter the animal and violate the Shabbos instead of feeding him non-kosher meat. Unless, of course, the urgency is so strong that there's a person who needs to eat right now and cannot even wait the prep time that it takes for kosher slaughter. Now, let's understand the basis for this ruling. Mishnah Berurah over there, Lamed Tes, and also Beis Yosef Yud Gimel in greater detail, summarizes the various reasons as to why slaughtering on Shabbos to feed the person kosher meat is preferable than feeding him available non-kosher meat. Number one, once there is an activation of a life-threatening situation, all laws of Shabbos that pertain to the needs of this person become moot. In Lamdus, this is known as Hutra instead of Hudcha. The entire situation permitted. Requirements of Shabbos are non-existent instead of merely allowed or waived. Consider the following. If a person threatens your life and you fight back and kill that person in self-defense, is this act murder but with a dispensation, or is it not even termed murder? In any case, according to the concept of Hutra, it is not that you are given a technical dispensation, but it is as if Shabbos is Tuesday in relation to any act performed to serve and save the person in danger. Thus, since Shabbos work is anyway fully permitted in this case, one may as well prepare kosher meat and slaughter the animal. Reason number two is, though Shabbos is a more severe prohibition than kashrus, as Shabbos violation is listed in the Torah as a chi of misa, as liable for the death penalty, while kashrus is only a standard losase, the accumulation of violations makes kashrus more severe. That is, slaughtering the animal is a one-time violation, while eating non-kosher food causes a continuous violation with every kazayas, every olive-sized portion that is consumed. Reason number three, there is a fear that the sick person will be disgusted by the idea of non-kosher and hold back from eating, which is necessary for his survival. Thus, preparing kosher food is not so much because of any prohibition for its own sake, but rather for the emotional comfort of the sick person so that he or she won't hold back from eating. Possible exceptions to this rule then can occur if the ill person is sure that he will not feel disgusted by the non-kosher meat, or if the ill person is a minor under Bar Bat Mitzvah. Since the minor is not obligated in the prohibition of non-kosher food, there's no rationale for a fully obligated Jew to violate Shabbos and slaughter an animal to prevent the child from eating non-kosher. Now, the most psychologically interesting feature of this discussion is reason number three. I suspect this comes up more often than we realize. How often might we refuse to follow medical advice because it feels wrong to miss out on a mitzvah or transgress, even if it is vital for health? How painful is it to not be able to fast on Yom Kippur? Or how difficult must it be to not wear tefillin if your digestive system is unstable and you really can't wear tefillin? The urge is to ignore the health concerns and just follow the ritual anyway. However, in doing so, we comfort ourselves with external compliance, which can have nothing to do with internal states. It can be a holier Yom Kippur to eat to save your life than the longest, most difficult fast. But it is always hard to feel that way at the time. It sure is easy to turn a mitzvah into an avera.